A very warm good morning to one and all present over here class. Welcome to the digital platform of APS. Now this is Pavan Kumar. Today I will start next lecture or fourth lecture of chapter 2, relation and function. So class, in previous lecture I have discussed relation function definition and also I have taken examples. Explanation of relation function with the help of examples I have completed. Now today I'll start with some particular types of relations. So see, some particular types of relations. Heading is some particular types of relation. So new heading is some particular types of relation. So I will come to the first relation. First relation type is void relation. Void relation. First type is void relation. Void relations. So what is void relation? So let capital A be any non-empty set and phi is a relation from A to A. Phi is a relation from A to A. Such that phi is a subset of A cross A. Phi is a subset of A cross A. Now phi is a subset, that is proper subsets. Phi is a subset or proper subset of A cross A. Then phi is said to be void relation, or in other words, or we can say, let capital A be any non-empty relations, non-empty sets, and phi is a relation such that phi is a relation that is from A to A, such that phi is a subset or proper subset of A cross A. So now then we can say phi is a relation on A is known as or said to be void relation or empty relation. Void relation or empty relation. This is known as void or empty relation. Now come to the next type. The next type is universal relation. Now what is universal relation? See, next heading is universal, or second type is universal relation. Now what is universal relation? How it can be defined? Let capital A be any non-empty set and U be a relation any relation from A to A, from A to A, such that U is a subset of A cross A, and U is equal to A cross A. Then the relation U is known as universal relation. U is known as universal relation. Now see, this is the definition of universal relation. Now I will come to the next relation, or in other words we can say A cross A is a subset of A cross A. This is universal relation, A cross A. Now I will come to the next definition. The next definition is identity relation. Identity relation. See, the third definition is identity relation. Third is identity relation. Identity relation. So what is identity relation? Let capital A be any non-empty set and I be any relation from A to A, such that IA, this is the symbolic representation of identity relation, IA that is equal to A comma A, such that small a belongs to capital A, curly bracket closed, is said to be, is known as identity relation. Identity relation. And it is denoted by I of A for non-empty sets. So you can take example. Capital A, if you will consider non-empty set that is 1, 2, 3, then identity relation from A to A, we can write I of A means A comma A, such that small a belongs to capital A, and we can write 1 comma 1, 2 comma 2, 3 comma 3. For this non-empty sets 1, 2, 3, this is the identity relation. Identity relation. Now this definition is completed. See, Now come to the next definition. The next definition is inverse relation. Inverse relation. Now see. Next heading is inverse relation. What is inverse relation? To define the inverse relation, first of all, you will consider capital A and capital B being in two sets. Let capital A and capital B be any two non-empty sets. And R be a relation from A to B. Then the inverse of relation R is denoted by R inverse and defined by through which expression you can define? Defined by R inverse is equal to B comma A, such that we can write B belongs to small b capital B and small b belongs to capital B and small a belongs to capital A and AB ordered pair that belongs to R. This is the mathematical terms of inverse of relation. Now this definition is completed. Now you will see in this relation there are two terms we have to find out. See, first is domain of inverse of relation, domain of R inverse and range of R inverse. So first of all, I will write domain of R inverse. In these statements, so there are node points. Domain of R inverse, that is always equal to domain of R inverse, that is always equal to what? The range of R. Range of R, we can write domain of R inverse means domain of R inverse inverse relation, that will be equal to range of R. And range of R inverse, what is the range of R inverse? That will be equal to domain of R. Next point, range of R inverse, that will be equal to the domain of R. See, this is the formula you can also learn. See everyone. This is very important relation. Always ask in your examination point of view. Now again see, to define inverse relation, you have to consider two non-empty sets, capital A and capital B, and R is a relation from A to B, you will consider. Then the relation or inverse of relation is denoted by, inverse of relation R is denoted by R inverse and defined by R inverse is equal to B, I ordered pair in curly brackets such that B belongs to B and small a belongs to capital A and AB belongs to R. Then domain of R inverse that will be equal to the range of R. Domain of R inverse that will be equal to range of R and range of R inverse that will be equal to domain of R. Now this is completed. See. Now class, I will start with a new topic, various type of relations. So new topic is various type of relations. See, heading is various type of relations. Various type. Relations. Various type of relations. Now in various type of relation, suppose to define various type of relation, you will consider any non-empty sets or there are three type of relation you will study in this relations. So first relation is reflexive relation. First type is reflexive. Reflexive relation. So what is reflexive relation? What is reflexive relation? Let capital A be any non-empty sets. Capital A be any non-empty set. And R is any relation, R be a relation. R be a relation. See, R be a relation on A. On A. Now R is said to be reflexive. The relation R is said to be reflexive if, what is the condition? If A related to A, A related to A, that for all belongs, all small a belongs to capital A. A small a belongs to capital A, this is the condition. It means if, we can write here, or in other words we can write a small a comma a, that is the ordered pair, that belongs to R, that belongs to R, and for all a small a belongs to capital A. This is the condition. If this condition will satisfied, then the relation is said to be reflexive. So see. Now I will come to the next relation, that is symmetric relation. So what is symmetric relation? See, New heading is symmetric relation. Second heading is symmetric relation. Symmetric relation. Now, a relation R is said to be symmetric relation. A relation R is said to be symmetric relation. What is the condition? Condition is if A related to B, if A related to B, this is read as if A related to B, this implies B will related to A. Or in other words, we can write if AB ordered pair belongs to R, this implies B comma A ordered pair will belongs to R. This is the condition which satisfied for symmetric relation. So, now come to the next definition, that is transitive relation. See, so what is transitive relation? See, third is transitive relation. Third is transitive relation. So, what is transitive relation? A relation R is said to be transitive relation on set A. On set A, consider if, what is the condition? If A related to B and B related to C, if A related to B and B related to C, this implies A related to C, A related to C. This is the condition for transitive. Now, in other words, if A comma B ordered pair belongs to R and B comma C ordered pair also belongs to R, this implies A comma C also well belongs to R. This is the condition for transitive. Now, what is anti-symmetric relation? What is anti-symmetric relation? See, now I will come to the next point or next heading, anti-symmetric relation. Fourth point is anti-symmetric relation. एंटीसिमेट्रिक रिलेशन. नाउ व्हाट इज एंटीसिमेट्रिक रिलेशन? एंटीसिमेट्रिक रिलेशन इज द एंटी प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ सिमेट्रिक रिलेशन. सो व्हाट वी कैन से अबाउट दिस? फॉर एनी और रिलेशन, a relation R is said to be anti-symmetric relation if A related to B is equal to B related to A. This implies we can write A is equal to B, or in other words we can write if AB ordered pair belongs to R, that is equal to B comma A ordered pair belongs to R. This implies A is equal to B. Now this is the anti-symmetric relation. Now come to the next relation, equivalence relation. Next relation is equivalence relation. Now what is equivalence relation? A relation R is said to be equivalence relation if R is reflexive, R is symmetric, and R is transitive. See, any relation R is said to be equivalence relation if R is reflexive, if R is symmetric, and if R is transitive. Then the relation R said to be equivalence relation. Now this definition or types of relation is completed. And this is the necessary condition for any relation R said to be reflexive, symmetric, equivalence relation. If any relation R equivalence, then these three conditions will be satisfied. And in case of reflexive, you know, for all AA belongs to R. In case of reflexive, ordered pair AA belongs to R, for all small a belongs to capital A. And in case of symmetric, you know, AB belongs to R. If AB belongs to R, this implies we can say B comma A will belongs to R. This is the condition for symmetric. And third for transitive is if AB belongs to R, A comma B ordered pair belongs to R, and B comma C ordered pair also belongs to R, this implies A comma C ordered pair also belongs to R. Now this is the condition for transitive. Now this all types of relation is totally completed. See everyone.